another day that God has made. All of us here at Mount Pleasant would like to thank each and every one of you for tuning in today. We hope that you had the mind that we had to come out and give God the praise because He's so worthy. I'm going to read you from John 3. There was a man of Pharisees named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. The same came to Jesus by night and said unto him, Rabbi, we know that thou art a teacher of come from God, for no man can do these miracles that thou does except God be with them. May the Lord have blessed the readers, hearers, and doers of this holy word.
Amen. This morning, we thank God, we thank you, Father, for giving us up this morning and start our way. Thank you, Lord, for protecting us last night, our stomach in our beds. And we got up this morning with a power in your hand, and we got up.
All right.
Thank you, Lord, for another day, Lord. Lord, so close to the end of the world. And Lord, I just thank you for another day. Lord, thank you for us. Thank us for another year.
Thank you.
We thank you, Lord, for the families still here. Thank you, Lord, for our health and strength. Thank you, Lord, for the homes we live, Lord. We thank you for everything. But most, Lord, we thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ. He's the one who made for us to live life. Now, Lord, forgive us for our sins, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for your mercy and your grace, Lord. We need you, Lord. Everything that's going on in this world, Lord, protect us daily, Lord. Protect our families, friends, and neighbors, Lord. Even our enemies, Lord, from the saints' sake. We thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
We can't do it by ourselves.
Every
day we look around and everything thing like it's going better, but then some go around. But only you, Lord, and only you control everything. We need to trust you, Lord, with all our heart. And everything will be all right. In your time, Lord, we just thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
And we praise you. And we lift you high. We thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Now, Lord, for this Thanksgiving season, remember those who don't have a home to live. Remember those who don't have no food. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
You know what we need. And you know what they need. We just thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Protect every home.
This
country. And the world, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Good morning, Mount Pleasant.
Good morning.
I said good morning, Mount Pleasant.
Good morning.
All right. Y'all wake up. It's time for service this morning. As I pulled into the parking lot, somebody stopped me. I ain't going to point no elbows at nobody, but somebody stopped me in the parking lot, and they wanted to hear a specific song. So I'm going to do my best to honor that this morning before we get started.
All right.
And if y'all know it, I know you know it. Just sing it along with me. Praise Him. Praise Him. Oh, praise Him. Why don't you praise Him? Jesus, our blessed Savior, He is worthy to be praised. Come on, somebody, and praise Him. Why don't you, praise Him? Oh, praise Him. Somebody ought to praise Him. He's Jesus, our blessed Savior. He is worthy, Yes, He is. Be praised. From the rising of the sun until the going down of the same, He is worthy. Jesus is worthy. He is worthy to be. Come on and praise Him. You ought to praise Him. Oh, praise Him. He is Jesus, our blessed Savior. He is worthy to be praised. Another verse that says, God is my rock. Yes, He is. He's my hope of salvation. I know He's a strong deliverer. Yes, He is, y'all. In Him will I always. Somebody ought to give Him glory in all things. You ought to give Him glory. Why? Because it's Jesus. He's our blessed Savior. He is worthy to be Now, we said that He's worthy to be praised. Yeah. Somebody ought to praise His name. Yeah. Just because He's Jesus, yeah, our blessed Savior, not because of what He's done, yeah, but just because of who He is. Yeah. Father, we lift Your name on this morning. Yeah.
All right.
I think I'm going to do one more small one. I see we've got a musician walking in the door here now. But this one is old school. Y'all come on and go back with me. We are often tossed and driven on these restless seas. We will understand it better by and by. Sound like y'all ready to sing out there this morning. All right, now, I'm going to bring it on home just a little bit here and tell you how precious His name is. Thank you. heart is filled with despair. Remember God's gifts. Thank you. My.
Yeah.
Thank you, God. Don't start looking for peace. My. Always have. Because we know that there's power there. Whatever it is that we may need, it's in the name of Jesus. We came to encourage somebody this morning. To tell you whatever the circumstances may be, whatever you're going through, however hard it may be, my brother and my sister, fight on to see what the end is going to be. Fight on, because God is walking by your side and everything is going to be all right. All you got to do is fight on.
Oh,
fight on. Keep on fighting. And keep on fighting. This race is not over. All you've got to do is fight. Oh,
your spirit upon me. Grant preaching power in this place. God, I ask now that you would do what you want to do in this house.
Yes.
We just want to leave here better than when we came. So have your way. You save the lost at any cost. Do what you need to do in this place. Nevertheless, let your will be done. In Jesus' name. Amen. Can we give the Lord a hand clap of praise in this house? Truly, God is worthy of all of our praise. We honor God, our Father, our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ, our comforter, teacher, and our guide, the Holy Spirit, to minister boldly to the officers of this church, to all of you God's children. I am so grateful to be here. I must admit, we have some amazing deacons and deaconesses. I was so encouraged and uplifted this week. We went over to Miss Mary Louise's house to give communion, and God moved in her house.
Amen. Yes, Lord.
And I'm so grateful for the members of this church. While it's on my mind, December the 13th, if I'm not mistaken, yes, December 13th at 5:30, we'll have our end of the year meeting, a church meeting. So please mark your calendars now. December 13th at 5:30, we'll meet here for our end of the year business meeting at that time. All right, that's a word I want to lift. Found in Psalms 119, the 119th number of the psalm. I want to read one verse in your hearing, verse 105. Psalms 119, verse 105. Psalms Psalms 119, verse 105. When you get there, you'll find these words recorded. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Amen. I want to tag this text with this subject. Just light it up in the night. Just light it up in the night. For those of us who are familiar with this text that I just read in your hearing, we recognize that as we live, it can get dark sometimes. I've come today to let you know that the darker it is, the brighter your light will shine. I don't care how dark it is, you will survive it. I don't care how black it is, you will get through it. I don't care what you're up against, you will overcome it. I don't care how low it is, you will get beyond it. And I wish I had some people in here who's going through some darkness right now that can hear God and not me. Listen, the darker it is, the brighter the light. It may be dark, but God has given you the light of his word, and his word will not fail. His word will see you through, and his word will be there for you when nobody else is. People of God, check this out. It's the Hebrew hymn book of the Psalm. There are 150 Psalms. This is the longest book in the Bible. It opens like this. Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law do he meditate both day and night. And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that bringeth forth his fruit in his season. His leaf shall not wither, and whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. And that lets you know, people of God, that there will be moments where you feel like you're all by yourself and you cannot make it. But the psalmist says in Psalms 23 that the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He lets us know that he leads me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake, which lets me know that no matter what anybody says, when you walk through the valley of the shadow of death, that you don't have to fear, because God is always with you. His rod and staff, it comforts you. He prepares a table before you in the presence of your enemies. He anoints your head with oil, and because you've been anointed, your cup runs over. Surely goodness and mercy, he says, will follow you all the days of your life, and you don't have to worry about who's got your back, because the Lord is with you forever and ever. Let's just know that there will be moments of tears and tears, because he says, in spite of all of that, in Psalms 30 and 5, the big clause, he says, weeping may endure for a night. But if you just muscle through the night, if you can just roll up your sleeves and say, I've come too far to quit, you'll discover that joy will come in the morning. Yes, there will be times when you feel like you're in the valley of life. But check this out. Psalms 121 says, I lift up mine eyes unto the hills from which cometh my help. My help don't just come from folk around me, but my help comes from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. He will not suffer thy foot to be moved. He
that keepeth Israel shall not slumber nor sleep. The Lord is thy keeper. The Lord is thy shade upon thy right hand. The sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. He says to us people of God in Psalms 126 and 5, that they that sow in tears shall reap with joy. Let us know that if you love God, and I need to see some people in here that can testify I love God. If you really love God, you ought to wave at me real quick. Because here is what the psalmist says in Psalms 34 and 19. Many are the afflictions of the righteous. God allowed you to go through moments of tears, tears, and toil. But the Lord will deliver you. Okay, wait, wish I had some people in here that's been delivered at least one good time. When God pulled you out of some stuff, God got you out of some stuff, the Lord will deliver you from them all. But then he lets us know that we ought to praise God. He concludes like this in Psalms 150, verse 6. He says, let everything. Oh God, let me. Let everything. Oh God, third time's a charm. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. And now, right in the heart of the psalm is Psalms 119. It's the longest of all the hymns. And if you notice, it's broken down into blocks of eight. And in every block of eight in Psalms 119, you'll notice a small caption at the top of it is written in Hebrew. And it's what they call the Hebrew alphabet. And the reason why they did that is because for every alphabet, that was a psalm. So by the time you get to Psalms 119 to 105, he says, then no matter what dark hour you find yourself in, thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. And I have been preaching this for the past several months because, listen, I cannot keep you from dark moments of despair. And if I could, y'all, I promise you I would. But I can't because God had orchestrated that. But what I can do, my pleasant, is equip you with the light that will help you light your way through. Listen here, you've got to have the word of the Lord. And I'm not talking about just, you know, a shot of the word on Sunday, but you need a word on Monday. You need a word on Tuesday. You need a word on Wednesday. You need a word on Thursday. You need a word on Friday. You need a word on Saturday. You need a word in your heart. You need a word for your enemies. You need a word for your friends. You need a word for your problems. You need to start telling your problems how big your God is instead of telling your God how big your problems are. You need a word from God. And is there anybody here that came for a word from God? You didn't come here to play church. You got too much going on in your life. And if you're here and you need a word from God, will you help me preach until I feel a little bit better and tell somebody it may be dark in my life, but I came here with the light. I've got the light of God's word. I've got the light of God's promise. I've got the light of God's prophecy. I've got the light of God's peace. I need a word from God. Three things that I'm out of here. Watch this. First of all, if you're going to just light it up in the night, I want to pick up three things. First of all, let's talk about the boldness of the night. Tell somebody the boldness of the night. Sister Daphne, listen. There's dark. There's real dark. There's black. And there's pitch black. Mama Mary, pitch black means you can't see your hand in front of your face. But here's what I've discovered. If it's real dark, you don't need a bright light to light some stuff up.
All right.
Just a little bit of light will make things shine.
Yes.
People of God, check this out. He says, and no matter what you may hear, the darkness is here.
Yes.
The reason why the psalmist mentions lamp and light is because lamps and lights are used for nocturnal existence. Listen, you do not need a lamp when the sun is shining. You do not need a lamp when it's light around you. But you need a lamp when there's darkness around you. See, check this out. The trick of the enemy is to get you away from God's word when you're going through stuff, so you can lean and learn how to listen to messed up advice from people whose lives are messed up as well. And I want to say to you today, stop taking advice from people with a wrecked life, trying to tell you what you ought to do with your life, and start leaning and getting God's word in your life. People of God, I need to tell you this. People will always give you free advice. When you ought to take God's word that he bled for you to have. Hear this announcement. You will have moments where it gets dark. But if you want to see the darkness shift, you need to have a lamp or a light around you. And that's because darkness defines moments for us. Check me out. Demons move in dark places. Hatred hangs out in the darkness of the soul. Despair is not in the daylight. Despair comes in dark times. And then the only way for you to deal with the darkness is for you to learn how to say to yourself, I've got a way to deal with the darkness. And that's for me to depend on what God has already said to me. Listen, I come today to inform you that when you get to the darkest place in your life, you got to learn how to open up your Bible and say, God, I need to hear from you. Can I tell you, the darkness may be real, but God's word ought to be your new reality. Let me hurry here. Not only do I see the boldness of the night, but secondly, check out the blessing of the Lamb. Tell somebody the blessing of the Lamb. Watch the text. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet. Listen, here is what the psalmist is saying. You need a lamp to discern things that are close to you. Oh God. You need God's word to determine whose company you ought to keep. Who's in your corner? Who's the person you ought to date? You ought to be able to have a word for those who are in close proximity. Because everybody that's in your corner ain't always your caliber. Y'all quiet in here. That's people that are smiling in your face, and they hate it when they see God bless you. But then there are other people that's not in your face, and they want to see God do great things for you. And the only way for you to discern that is for you to have a word from God that's your standard. Because watch this, at the end of the day, you need to have a biblical standard for your life. You don't need to be hanging out with people who will just sing and celebrate what they are doing. Listen, everybody's singing, I got that. We all make mistakes, I got that. Nobody is perfect, I understand that. But if you're going to be near people that's headed to hell, and then they want you to come with them, you ought to have your head examined right along with theirs. Because the Bible says, people of God, in Proverbs 16 and 25, that no matter what anybody says, there's a way that seemeth right unto man, but the end thereof are ways of death. And I say to you today that when the Bible becomes your standard, standard. When the Bible becomes your standard, I said, when the Bible becomes your standard, you'll have standards all around yourself. Listen, you don't just call me anything, but you got to either call me by my name or tell me I'm a child of God. I don't just answer to any name that you call me. Listen, the Bible helps you raise a standard. And I wish I had some people in here who've seen God raise a standard in your life to look at somebody and tell them, I am blessed. I'm not cursed. I am moving forward. I am the head and not the tail. I am above and not beneath. I am a child of God. The boldness of the night. It will get dark in your life. Mama, that blessing of the lamp. It helps you discern what's near you. But then finally, check this out. There's a word about the benefit of the light. I'll tell somebody benefit of the light. When the night is dark. Deacon Ron, you don't need a lot of light to make a light shine. You just need a little bit of light. Check out the text. Thy word is a lamp. It lets you see what's around unto my feet. And a light is like a torch. And a torch was like a huge flashlight. Deacon Clarence, it wouldn't just light up the nearby proximity, but it would give you a future forecast of what's coming down the road. And I want to suggest to you that the only book in the world that's loaded with what's down the road is the Bible. That's why many of our churches are in the dark. Because we don't preach what's in the book. But y'all quiet in here. That shows you what's coming. But I want to tell you today that I can see your future. And you look good. You will not look like what you've been through. You will not look like you've been defeated. You will look like you are a mountain moving, life changing child of God. When you get in the dark, and I'm out of here when I tell you, when you get in the dark, you got to learn how to just turn on the light. Because God has a reason for you to keep on living. God has a reason why you ought to keep on pressing. God has a reason why you ought to keep on moving on. And I wish I had some people that'll make up in their minds that I will let God's word my life. That's what Paul says in Philippians 3:14, that I will press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. And is there anybody here who's going to make up in your mind that I'm pressing on? As a matter of fact, Job 14:14 says that all the days of my appointed time will I wait until my change comes. And is there anybody here that needs a change to come in your life? If you need a change, I need you to help me through here. And just look at somebody and say, neighbor, I'm here today. change for better. I need to change for greater. I need to change for stronger. It might be darker, but you've got to let his word light up your life. The Bible says in Romans 8 and 28, he said, and we know that all things work together for the good for those who love God and those who are the called according to his purpose. And I need you to help me preach until I feel a little bit better, and just encourage somebody and say, neighbor, it might be dark, but he's working it out and he's doing it right now. It's got to get better, because the Bible says in Psalms 103 verse number 2, it says, bless the Lord, oh my soul, and forget not all his benefits. Bless the Lord, in spite of your heartaches, in spite of your headaches, in spite of the hills, in spite of the valleys you face, in spite of the difficulty. Bless the Lord, like you trust in the Lord. Can I tell you how to light up your life when you get in darkness and you feel lonely? Light up your life with his word. In Matthew 28 verse 20, but because it says, Lord, I'm with you always, even to the end of the world. When you're burdened, light up your life with his word. Matthew 11, 29 and 30 says, take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light. When you're oppressed and afflicted, light up your life with his word. Psalms 34 and 19 says, many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord will deliver them out of them all. When you face enemies and the hound dogs of hell, light up your life with his word. Isaiah 54, 17 says, no weapon that's formed against me shall prosper. When you don't know what to do, light up your life with Proverbs 3:5-6. He says, trust in the Lord with all thine heart. Lean not to thine own understanding. In all thy ways, you gotta acknowledge him, and he will direct you. But with prayer and thanksgiving, you gotta make your request known unto God, and the peace of God that surpasses all understanding shall guide your heart and your mind through Christ Jesus. All I'm trying to tell you, you gotta learn how to open the book and let the book light up your life. If you're in darkness, open the book. Let it be a lamp to your feet and a light to your path. Shout yes. Shout yes. Gotta make sure. Gotta make sure that I let the word of God light up my life. I need his word to be a lamp so I can see what's nearby. I can discern those things. But then I need this word to be a light to my path so I can see what's up the road. Family, we all face darkness. And during this time and season, it's been documented that it is the most darkest time in the lives of people. If you're going to get through the darkness of light, just light it up with his word as we offer Christ. This is your moment now to come to Jesus. The Bible said, if thou confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, believe in thine heart, Christ was raised from the dead. He says, thou shalt be saved. If salvation is what you need, he died for you to have it. He got up so you could have it. And we're waiting on his return. But while I'm waiting, I've got to keep worshiping. I've got to keep watching. Because I want to be ready when the Lord returns. If you're here, make him your choice. I need the Lord to guide me every day, every day. As I travel along this every second, every
every minute, every hour, every day. So have your way now. Bless the gift as well as the giver. Let it be used for kingdom building and kingdom business. Now, God, as we leave this place, but never from your presence, keep us safe now. Show yourself mighty and strong. I pray, God, that we will all have a safe and prosperous Thanksgiving holiday. Bless those who are traveling. Touch those in a special way, God. And all will be well. I'm praying for Pastor Wiley and his entire family. Keep them safe, cover them, protect them. We thank you for them. Lift up their bowed down heads, ease their troubled minds. I pray for peace now that surpasses all understanding. Nevertheless, let your will be done. In Jesus' name, amen.